tongue. Alabama's about a touchdown favorite, a little bit more. So in the All-State Sugar Bowl tonight, David Pollack, Danny Cannell, and Mac Brown join us. David, who's going to win the Sugar Bowl?
Yeah, the Ohio reference there, Reese. I liked it. when you look at this game, I tell you what, I think Ohio stays a year ahead of schedule. I think they're right about that. I think next year they'll be my preseason number one team with all they have coming back. But Alabama this year, too big in the trenches, too physical up front. I think Alabama wins the ball game.
Two of the most talented teams in the country, maybe the two best coach teams in the country. Both of them had great years. I'm going with the older quarterback, though. It's hard to win with your third quarterback. I'm going Alabama.
I was really tempted to switch this pick after watching the disaster unfold for the SEC West the last couple of days. But ultimately, Alabama, as they've been the last 4 or 5 years, they're in another class than the rest of the SEC, even the SEC West. I don't trust Cardale Jones in his second start ever to go up against a Nick Saban defense with extended time. I think it could get ugly, too. I think Alabama wins comfortably.
All right, so it's a clean sweep up top for Alabama. What say you?
I think that Cardale Jones is going to be stressed mentally and physically. He's never been in that situation. It's 5 quarters of football. He's never had to play from behind and felt the stress of going out there and leading this team to a score that is either going to lead this team or either tie a game. He's always played ahead. I think this is going to be a game where he's going to be stressed physically with the blitz. I have Alabama beating Ohio State.
Good pick. Good pick.
Thank you,
I'm picking Alabama in their balanced offense to outscore the Buckeyes by a touchdown, an extra point, and a field goal.
I think what David said is right. Reese, you indicated this as well. Urban Meyer has been trying to rebuild Ohio State to get them to compete with Alabama. He may be a year ahead of schedule right now, the fact that he got his team into this game. I would argue this is the best coaching job he's done as a head coach, getting a team to this point in the season. If JT Barrett were quarterbacking this team, I'd probably pick Ohio State to win the game. But with Cardale Jones, just because of the unknown, how will he perform against a great coach in this setting? I'm going with Alabama as well.
Everybody with Alabama across the board, and now the game we'll see here in the Rose Bowl.
They're coming for us, and we're coming for them.
It's going to be a bloodbath, the quarterback said. That bloodbath's up your alley.
Bloodbath, like a bloodbath.
Gives the key to it.
Ohio State's offense has improved so much from the Virginia Tech game. This is the night we find out, has Ohio State's offense improved, or is it just because of who they have played? Tonight, they're going up against one of the best defenses in the country. So tonight, we find out one way or another, Dez, how much JT Barrett and that Buckeye offense has improved because of that defense.
I know I'm so comfortable right now with Connor Cook as a quarterback. I mean, a year ago, this kid, he didn't have a lot of confidence right now. He's played in these big games, been on the big stage, won 2 MVPs, Big Ten Championship, Rose Bowl. I got Michigan State beating Ohio State because of Connor Cook.
A momentary cheer for 15 seconds over the ground here in East Lansing.
I don't see how Michigan State can lose this game. Michigan State.
Emphatically.
Emphatically. Yes. Embarrassingly.
Embarrassingly.
Whoa.
Mr. Corso, you look padded up there.
First thing, I put 250 mascots in. My first one was Brutus the Buckeye. Watch this. Oh.
96.
Of course, I love Brutus. He's my favorite. Yeah. But that was then, and now is now. This is strictly business. And this is Sports!
Let's go right at the top. I think we know who it's going to be, one of the two SEC teams. It is Georgia. Georgia has a better marquee win than Alabama. Let's look at number two. It's going to be Alabama, right? The two? It is.
Yeah.
So 1 and 2, Alabama. Register your level of surprise.
Not so surprised because yeah. Georgia has a better resume. I think both pass the eye test. Both people blow everybody out. And what I was talking about, perspective wins, when Georgia beat Mississippi State 31-3, that was very impressive. Mississippi State at the time was unbeaten. They had just smashed LSU. So that was all. We talked about the Notre Dame win. That was big. But there are other little wins that I think are feathers in the hats as well.
Well, and not surprised at all. And this tells me that the committee is looking at the tape and watching, because throughout the season, these two teams have been the two best teams when you turn the tape on, playing game in and game out there, handling their business.
When
so I like
looking at the tape book and say watching, are you telling me when you watch Alabama and Georgia play, you're telling me you think Georgia's a better team than Alabama? I understand resume. I understand that they're not going to give them a lot of credit for beating Alabama. But when I watch these two teams play on tape, I do not feel as if Georgia is better than Alabama.
We'll get to that in just a minute. I want to show you number three. That is exactly as it should be. I could not be in more agreement with the committee with having Notre Dame number three with the schedule they played, the wins they have, the 1-point loss to number one. They deserve to be.
And the way they look right now, the way they looked against USC, the way they looked against NC State, and I had them at number three in my own poll, even though, Reese, I didn't want to give you credit, and I said I was sleeping on them early, they woke me up. And to be honest with you, I don't know how far Wimbush can take them with his arm. He is starting to throw some touchdown passes. I just don't know if he can get them over the top if he has to.
But the style of play that they have, they understand who they are. They have the best offensive line in football, and they run the football. And Wimbush doesn't have to do a lot. He's only going to have to make two or three key passes a game. And if he does that, Notre Dame has a formula, Joey. They can win.
Are there three more physical teams ever in the top three than these three right here?
Slobber knockers.
You know what? All of that, spread them out.
Exactly.
907 drill. Downhill.
Let's look at number four. Who's sitting in four?
All right.
The Clemson Tigers, only the loss to Syracuse, the extenuating circumstance of Kelly Bryant being injured. So we have Clemson at number four. Who's just behind at number five? Oklahoma. So there's valuing the head-to-head, so that leaves Ohio State. So the Buckeyes are going to be sitting at number six.
Takes it 79 yards to the house.
Don't want to hear about it.
Pistol formation, Barrett at quarterback, Elliott at tailback. Snap to JT Barrett, takes the hand, looks to throw from the 50. Guns it long, going Devin Smith toward the end zone, got it! Six for Devin Smith as he caught that one streaking down the right side. JT Barrett finds him on a 44-yard pass play. The second straight scoring play those two have hooked up on. And Ohio State has a 27-20.
Yeah, but that's what I'll do. In the feeling coming from my bones, that's my dog.
Right corner of the end zone, caught by Dontre Wilson for a touchdown. Dontre Wilson in the right corner of the end zone makes the touchdown catch of 7 yards. He beat R.J. Williamson to the spot for the football, and Ohio State has a 47. Coming left side to the 15, to the Spartan 10, to the 5, and to the end zone, Ezekiel Elliott with his second touchdown of the night on a 17-yard run.
I'm going to Wichita, far from this opera forevermore. I'm going to work the straw, make the sweat drip.
Runner, right? Barrett, who had an incredible fourth quarter, finds Johnny Dixon over the middle, touchdown. Buckeyes down. Barrett gets the ball back. 4.5 to play. To Dixon again in the end zone. They go for two and don't get it, so the Buckeyes are down by Barrett. Gets the ball back. Less than 2 minutes ago, he's looking for Marcus Ball, and he found him for a score, and OSU takes their first lead on field goal. But it's 4th and 15. McSorley under pressure. Comeback complete. Buckeyes win. Jenny Taft with JT Barrett afterward.
Slaughter to the sideline, caught first down.